Yes, good morning, students. Let us have the introduction to JICS. Myself, PNS Sinvas from Kodlavalai Engineering College. So, let us have the introduction of JICS and fixtures. And basically, JICS are the important tools or the devices which are highly used in the production process. And which are mainly used in the mass production process. Already you might know what is meant by production. So production is a process in which the material will be processed from raw material to final inspection. So in that, let us have the introduction of what is the importance of JICS and fixtures in the production process. So the successful implementation of any production process relies on the interchangeability to facilitate each assembly. Okay. So there are three concepts. One is an trial and error, and second one is an selective assembly, and third one is an interchangeability. So when there is an interchangeability of a parts, then only we will have the maximum efficiency of a process. If the parts produced in a lot of quantities and if they are not interchangeable, then the entire thing will be of a waste of use. So then, reduction of unit cost. So cost reduction is very vital, important. And the mass production methods. So mass production, this is one of the production process. So mass production, job shop production, and the batch production, and demand a fast and easy method of positioning work pieces for accurate operations. So here, when you take into consideration of this mass production is means producing of a quantity in larger units, either it may be from 100 to 1000 or 10,000 or lakhs. So for that, we need to have a easy method of positioning of the work pieces, and due to when there is a fixation of the work pieces, then only we will have the accurate operations performed, either it could be a turning. So these are the operations performed, like just as turning, milling, shaping, drilling, etc., etc. All these kinds of machining process will be produced on it. The JICS and fixtures are the production tools used to accurately manufacture duplicate and interchangeable parts. Okay. So JICS and fixtures are mainly used to manufacture products in an accurate and specific manner, and to have interchangeable parts. Mainly these are used in the mass production. Why? Because there is no change in the methodology, no change in the dimension, no change in the process. Okay, so the same process is continued for the entire object. For example, if you take a bolt and nut, a shaft, a crank, or a piston. Okay, so it is having the mass production. In automobile industry, the piston is uniform to all one specific. For if it is a two-stroke, for if it is a four-stroke engine, generally there are no two-stroke engines. And now we'll have a four-stroke engine. Four-stroke engine will have a common piston design. Okay, so piston is a common thing. The crankshaft is a common thing. Next is a connecting rod is a common thing. So the parts are produced in lakhs and lakhs, and if it is a worn out, it should be interchangeable. Otherwise, it is a waste of money. Next, JICS and fixtures are specifically designed to design so that large number of components can be machined or manufactured, and to ensure interchangeability of the. So the same point in the above manner is being elaborated. Now let us see a small video on what is kind of these JICS and fixtures. So now, if you see in this, if you see in this, it is a jig. Okay. So where we have four holes on it, and these four holes are the ones which will be guiding the tool. Okay. Here we will fix the workpiece, and this workpiece is we want to manufacture in a lot of things. Means we need to get into a vast amount. For this, these holes are set or set up in such a way that the on these holes or in these hollow parts, the tool will proceed, and then we'll have the okay. Actually, this is a drilling jig. So these are according to these holes, the tool will be guided. So therefore, jig is a one which is a bifunctional. Means it not only holds the workpiece but also what you call the guides the tool. Okay, now if you see this, so it is here. I said it is a metal working tool used to hold the workpiece and to guide the tool during the machining process. If you see this, a radial jig, a radial drilling machine. There is a motor, this is the under motor, and this is the column in which this is the drill point. Okay, so this is what is the drill bit. And now this is where we keep the workpiece. Now this drill will be approaching the workpiece in this manner. Okay, so here we need to produce the holes in a circumferential manner. So hence, it guides the tool to drill in that position. So that is, this is the part is what is called as a lead jig. Okay. Next, if you proceed further, so this is also vice is already, you know, this is used to hold the workpiece. Okay, so this will not guide the machine tool. This is a simple vice, so it is called as a carpenter vice. Okay, now if you take a turning fixture, okay, so fixture is a one which will only holds the workpiece. It is nothing to do with the machining process. Means it doesn't guide the tool. So this is how this is what is the face plate of. Okay, now so this is how we'll see, this is the face plate of it, and this this is used for the turning fixture. Now and this is fastened like this, and this is kept in the check. Okay, so and in this check, what will happen means we'll have a 3-jaw check or a 4-jaw check, etc. Okay, so depending on that, we'll be placing that jig with the fixture, and the workpiece is fixed here. Okay, we'll have a a tool post, and the tool post will be manufacturing the part. Means we'll carry out the machining process, that is the turning operation. Means removal of the material circumferential. Now, if you see this, so same what you called as a jig. Okay. Now, if you see here, so this is the drill bit, and this is the workpiece, and this this is what is called, this is the guide for the tool. And this is the locating pin. This is where is the work is located. Now, if you take the fixture, the work is fixed here. Okay, and these are the bolts and nuts arrangement and clamping arrangement. So this is how a workpiece has been fixed in a turning operation. Okay. So this is what is the schematic diagram of jigs and fixtures. Now already you know it is holds and supports the workpiece and guides the cutting tool for a specific operation. Okay, so these are usually fitted with hardened steel bushing or guiding or other cutting tools. Okay, now you can see already in the above video we have shown that it not only holds the workpiece but also guides the tool. Okay, so these are actually manufactured cast steel or what you call the mild steel. So these are the fitted with hardened steel. Okay, hardened steel bushings will be there for guides. Okay, so for guidance to the cutting tools. Next, a jig is a type of a tool used to control the location and or motion of another tool. Okay, so jig primary purpose is to provide repeatability, accuracy, and repeatability means so repetition of the process. Okay. Why? Because in mass production, so the repetition of the process is higher. So if you want to take out the material, so that is if a rod is having the diameter of 30, we need to manufacture to 25. So directly we cannot take the 5 mm. Depending on depth of cut, will be maximum to 1 mm. We'll be getting into 29, 28, 27, and 26, and after 25. So this is in what you call the repeating operation. Okay. So repetition of the process. So if you want to grind and workpiece, so grinding operation, that is the repetition of the process. If you want to drill a workpiece of so and so 10 mm, so we need to drill up to 10 mm. Cannot go beyond 10 mm. So if there is an enlargement of the hole, then we need to go to a reamer. Okay, we cannot go through the drilling is a rough hole production. Now if you want to have enlarging of the hole, smoothing of the hole, then we need to get into another tools. And interchangeability of the machining parts or the manufacturing the device that is a multifunctional. So that's why I already said that it is a multifunctional. Holding and guiding the tool is called a jig. Next, if a key, let us take in for a simple process. If you suppose a key has been lost, suppose if a key is to be duplicated. Now, the initial key, we need to make a stamp. The initial key will be make it as a jig, and so that a new key will be follow the same path as of the old key. So that's what is the a simple example of a jig. So jigs and fixtures are a special purpose tool which are used to facilitate production mass. So that's what we said in the mass production. They eliminate the necessity of a special setup for each individual part. Okay, for every part. Suppose the same process to be produced. Okay, now when you interchange the part, then there is a loss in the machining time, there is a loss in the manpower, there is a loss in the production process. To eliminate all these unnecessary times, we will be taking into the process of or taking into the methodology of arranging a jig. So they provide a means for manufacturing interchangeable parts. They establish a relation between tool and work with predetermined tolerance. So tolerance is a basic or important vital role playing in the machining process. And every part cannot be manufactured to its exact scale. Suppose if it is a part which is produced say as 25, cannot produce a part with 25 mm. We need to have a 25 mm plus or minus. So that is what plus or minus, say it is a bilateral tolerance. Given it is a plus, it is called as a unilateral tolerance. Or a simple minus, it is called as a bilateral tolerance. Suppose if it is given 25 minus 0.02, so that is 24.98. The part should be produced within the limits of 24.98 to 25. So the tolerance is nothing but it is the difference between upper limit and lower limit. So once the jig or fixture is properly set up, any number of same parts may be repaired or readily produced without any additional setup. Okay. So already I said, so suppose if a jig or a fixture is properly set up, then we can produce a number of parts without any additional setup. What are the uses of jigs and fixtures in manufacturing? So the production cost will be reduced. So production rate will be increased. Okay, maybe because so rapid production, so ensure high accuracy. Maybe because we have a higher production rate. Okay, so quality is also very very important. Not only we will focus on the quantity, we should focus on the quality. We should have high accuracy in part manufacture. And heavily, highly complex parts are being held rigidly in the machine. Suppose if the heavily parts, if it is a simple part, we can fix easily. But if it is a complicated part, if it is having number of contours, then we cannot fix easily part of a machine. For that, we need to have a special fixtures or a special jigs. So for that, a special setup. For that, jigs and fixtures are playing a vital role in order to hold that kind of work to provide interchangeability. Okay, reduce quality control expenses. Okay, less skilled labor and labor cost. So improving work safety. So now here we will see what is the possibility of producing a lot of parts without jig and fixtures, with jig and fixtures. So using automatic special purpose machine. Okay, the selection of an appropriate mode is governed by technological feasibilities in these modes. That is availability of the resource and facilities for the different modes, economic viability means economical availability of the parts, cost of manufacturing based on the cost of the basic machine, the cost of jigs and fixtures. Even though jigs and fixtures are having high cost or medium to high cost, but these are necessary. Why? Because without jigs and fixtures, even though the part will be produced at that instant in an accurate manner, but in the future due course, we cannot produce in an accurate manner. Okay, as the parts proceeds from 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and if the machine goes on, the vibration, chattering, all these efforts comes into consideration. For that consideration, we need to compulsory take into consideration of adopting the jigs and fixtures. So importance in industries. So why it is important in industries? Locate parts for precision. Okay, so precision and accuracy. So precision is a one which is up to the decimal value. Suppose if you want to produce a component of 24.998, you see after the decimal there are, after the decimal there are three digits. In order to have that much accuracy, that much precision, ordinary machines with no special setups can produce these parts. So for that, we want to locate the parts for high precision compulsory, we need to get into the concept of jigs and fixtures. Repeating process on a series of parts. So a repeating process, already we have said mass production, there is a repeating process. Okay, series of parts, the repetitive operation can be performed easily and accurately and in precision. So holding parts for what you call the machining, painting and assembly. Even for robotics, even if it is the automobile industry, an aeronautical industry, or in a space-related industry, you can carry it out in an easy manner. So now, if you take these diagrams, so this is C. So this is how welding of automobiles. So see, this is an automobile part, and this is the part, or this is the welding operation which is performed here. So this is the part here, and now this is what is called the jig. Okay, it is not only holding the workpiece, but on these guiders and guide locators, so we will having the welding operation to be carried out. Now similarly, if you take a paint shop, so now we want to paint this structure. So this is a complicated structure. For that, we need to have a sophisticated equipment. So then jigs and fixtures are playing the vital role. Now if you take a composite material, so if this is a composite material for which we need to perform some specific operation, for that jigs and fixtures are playing a vital role. Okay. Thank you.